Hello everybody, my name is Justin Miller from the ReactOS Community YouTube channel, and today we're going to be talking about the X64 port of ReactOS once again, and showing off Blender working in our port. Recently, the 64-bit port has been exponentially improving, getting more stable and more features added, and it's starting to get better. Currently on Master, if you take a debugger and bypass an assert, you can even boot to the desktop. See, even without WoW 64, there are some programs that will work on our X64 port. Blender's a 3D modeling application that's been around for quite some time now. As you might have guessed from the title, or the introduction to the video, Blender, a certain version of it anyway, is actually working on X64 ReactOS. As you can see, Blender is really responsive. Most of the controls are responding instantaneously, and there's very minimal issues occurring in just common usage. Even in the VM state, it seems we're working pretty well. Part of this is actually due to the SVGA driver. The user Ellen in the ReactOS community Discord server managed to create a PR and a patched ISO that allows ReactOS to use the X64 SVGA driver in VMware. This allows for basic graphics acceleration inside the virtual machine, and it makes 3D applications work relatively quicker. For example, you can quantify this by looking at the OpenGL test done by Winterhell in the ReactOS community Discord server. Our frames per second is actually much higher than it is without the graphics acceleration, and, to add another note of it, compared to even just without graphics acceleration, this number is a lot higher than it was a month ago, compared to older X64 ReactOS on a private branch. Either way, back to Blender for a minute. Here, we can see a render test being done. Or a crash, because it's alpha. Now you can see a render being done properly. Although we aren't doing any advanced shapes, you can see that it is pretty responsive and it is capable of doing the render. This is extremely impressive as it's one of the first 3D tests done for X64 ReactOS. Now if you're a Twitter follower, you'll know this already, but on top of the things being outlined in this video, there's also been other improvements done into the X64 port, like addressing and using a high amount of RAM. If you'd like to see updates as they happen, go ahead and follow the ReactOS Twitter, which of course is linked down below in the description. If you're wanting to test X64 for yourself without having to deal with the assert, Ellen in the ReactOS community Discord, and who's also part of our media group, has created an ISO which I linked down below which will allow you to boot. Okay, hang on, wait a second. Is that new? When did they add that? Okay, I updated this yesterday. When did this come in? When did Windows start showing the f***ing weather on the taskbar? Wait. These are f***ing ads? Oh my god, this is why I'm working on this project. Holy crap, who asked for this? Did I opt in for this? I didn't install anything for this. I hope you've enjoyed the video and enjoyed seeing how fast the 64-bit port has progressed. This has been a video by the ReactOS Community YouTube channel. We hope to see you all in the community.